Good morning and welcome to day 18 of our 21-day devotion and prayer. We're talking about prayer. We talked about the power of prayer. We talked about how do we receive power in prayer. We talked about different aspects of prayer. Yesterday we talked about what are the conditions that we need to meet in order to pray. And yesterday we looked at the first prayer requisite from the scriptures, that we must have an honest relationship with God in order to have God hear our prayers. That's one. Today we're going to look at a few more prayer requisites with regards to prayer. The second one is this, that you must have a forgiving attitude towards others. The first one requires you to have an honest relationship with God. But the second one requires to have an honest relationship with others. An honest relationship with others can only be possible with a forgiving attitude. In Mark chapter 11 verses 24 and 25, Bible says this, "Therefore I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it and it will be yours. And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive him, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you of your sins." You remember in Matthew chapter 6, the same thought Jesus teaching about prayer says in verses 14, chapter 6 of Matthew, in prayer, there is a connection between what God does and what you do. You can't get forgiveness from God, for instance, without also forgiving others. If you refuse to do your part, you cut yourself off from God's part. So it's very simple and straightforward. If my relationship with others is hurt by unforgiveness, I must offer forgiveness. You see, we can quench the Holy Spirit through unforgiving spirit. The effective and powerful working of the Holy Spirit in our lives is pictured as fire in scriptures. When we hold a grudge against someone, whether we feel we are justified in holding that grudge or not, we quench the powerful working of the Holy Spirit in our lives. When this happens, there is no power in our prayers. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 15 says, "Watch out that no bitterness takes root among you. For as it springs up among you, it causes deep trouble, hurting many in their spiritual lives." Think about that. God cares more about our spiritual health than keeping score about our hurts. Didn't he himself demonstrate this on the cross? We are to have forgiving attitude. Maybe you're praying and not getting an answer because you are holding a grudge against somebody. In Matthew chapter 5, Jesus says, if you're standing before the altar in the temple, offering a sacrifice to God, and you suddenly remember that someone has something against you, leave your sacrifice there beside the altar, go and be reconciled with that person, then come and offer your sacrifice to God. One of the primary reasons why people never see answers for their prayers is because they allow bitterness to spring up in their lives. They allow their relationship with people affect their relationship with God. So the second condition is simple. Develop a forgiving attitude towards others. There's a third condition for prayer. Is this, you must be willing to share the results of your prayer with others. Selfishness is a big stumbling block. Well, selfishness is a big wall that stops your prayers from becoming a reality. It hinders our prayers. Generosity, on the other hand, helps the prayers to go up and become powerful. Proverbs chapter 21 verses 13, Bible says, "If a man shuts his ears to the cry of poor, then he too will cry out, but his prayers will not be answered." I mean, how much more straight God can get, right? Do you want to be a container or a channel of God's blessing? God doesn't want us to hoard his blessings. In James chapter 4 verses 3, when you ask, you do not receive because you ask with wrong motives, and then that you may spend all that you receive for your own pleasures. Dead Sea is a classic example of it. Dead Sea is dead because it has no outlet. That's why it's become dead. Churches and Christians that want to receive blessings from God but don't want to share them with others are like the Dead Sea. You don't want to be like a Dead Sea. Check your motive when you're asking to God. That's the second, third condition. There's a fourth condition for prayer. That is this. You must believe that God will answer your prayer. You must believe that God will answer your prayer. In Matthew chapter 9, verses 27 to 30, we read, as Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, calling out, "Have mercy on us, Son of God." When he had gone indoors, the blind man came in and he asked them, "Do you believe that I'm able to do this?" "Yes, Lord," they replied. Then he touched their eyes and said, "According to your faith, will it be done to you?" And their sight was restored. Faith simply believes in God. To pray in faith is simply to pray believing that God has heard your prayer and God will do what you have asked him to do, and he will do what he has said. Rick Warren, a famous pastor, says this. Faith in prayer is not believing that he can do it or that he might do it or that you hope that he will do it. Faith believes that he will do it. To pray in faith is to pray according to what God has said he will do, not on what you want him to do. Jesus said in John chapter 15, verses 7, "If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be given to you." So in the Christian life, we get what we expect. Remember that. And when you pray in faith and expect God to do what he says he will do, in his word, he will do. You get what you expect from God. And the fifth condition for prayer is this, that you must pray in Jesus' name. It's the right name. In John chapter 14, verses 13 and 14, Jesus promises us, "I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it." By this, Jesus meant that we are to ask Father whatever we wish according to Jesus' authority as his Son. It is not to be just a magical, you know, a magical saying or a tag we tag on to the end of prayer. If we don't have the other four conditions in place, asking Jesus' name won't make any difference anyway. So asking in Jesus' name is not just some kind of magical formula we add at the end of prayer. It simply means this, that we are recognizing our own unworthiness and God's unconditional grace through Jesus to us. That's what we're saying. So we are coming with all our prayers, all our requests to him, and we are saying, "God, this is what is happening in my life. This is what we want you to do for us. But we're asking all this in the name of Jesus." When we are doing that, we are saying, "God, all my prayers, all my requests, you don't have to hear. I mean, we are not even worthy to come to you and ask you for this. We can't do anything to earn a right to ask you these things. There's nothing we can do, God. We recognize our unworthiness. But we come to you, not in our name, but in the name of Jesus." That's what we're saying. But in the name of Jesus, your Son. Your Son, his name makes it possible for us to come into your presence. And for us to offer ourselves, offer our petitions and prayers to you, our supplications to you. So please, for the sake of Jesus' name, hear our prayers and answer our prayers. That's what we are saying when we come in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So it's very simple. When you come to Jesus, when you come to God in prayer, come in the name of Jesus, because you can't represent, we are not worthy to come to him. But in the name of Jesus, we are worthy now because of the blood of Jesus Christ. And we come with this heart that is forgiving towards others, that is willing to share with others, that is willing to be generous towards everybody else, others, that is willing to believe that God will do whatever he says he will. And when we ask with that motive and that name of Jesus, all things are possible. So when you pray today, pray with that confidence that you can come into the presence of God in the name of Jesus by faith with the right motive. Anything you ask,